All right, Lucas, go ahead. Start it.
Start what?
The podcast.
Welcome to the Lucky Dogs Cast 43.
43? Yeah. I thought it was like 45.
43. It's 43. We skipped like
and
1 week.
And it's E3, basically.
Yeah.
Wait, let's talk about anime first.
Whoa, this
what's
guy
the, what's there? What's there to talk away. About?
Yeah, what is there to talk about in anime?
What is there to talk about? I guess the new season's coming out, right?
Are the old seasons already done?
Yeah, this is the last week, right?
It is? Wait, but Attack on Trains only had episode 9. It hasn't even finished all 11 episodes.
Oh, well, maybe Attack on Trains is on a different schedule, but I know this
well,
is like...
Well, Attack on Trains is on the Noi Tamina schedule. I don't know if that's different from the other stuff.
I don't even know what you just said.
Noi Tamina, it's like...
Animation backwards?
Well, it is animation backwards, but it's like...
Wait, really?
Yeah, Noi Tamina. It's animation backwards.
That's crazy.
But it's like a block of TV on one of their channels, like our Toonami or something. Yeah. And so they always have 11 episodes instead of like 12 or 13.
Well, new season starts in 2 weeks, actually.
Alright, well, why don't we wait until next week when Ray's here and everything, and then we can talk about the anime.
Yeah, because I want to talk about a specific anime.
Yeah, and then you can talk to Ray about the anime, because he's the anime man and you're anime man number two.
No, Bummy is anime man number two.
No, he's not. Bummy, do you accept that?
No.
Okay, then you're
anime. I definitely don't know anime as much as you guys.
No, you're anime man number two.
Wait, you guys, I don't even know what Noi Taname is, or whatever you said.
Wow, what's your faker. He's a faker.
My point is, I can't be anime guy number two.
You can be anime girl number one.
Yeah, that would be great.
Now that we're not going to talk about anime, Lucas, why don't you tell us what you've done in the past couple of weeks?
Nothing at all.
How? It's been like weeks.
And?
You must have gotten like the chance to do anything.
No.
Like, literally, you can do literally anything. And all you did was sit in your house and play Overwatch?
No.
What else did you do?
Just the usual.
Which is?
Nothing.
No.
You making music?
Of course.
Yeah, how's that going though?
It's real good.
Alright.
Wait, who just deleted it?
Oh, now it's just two lines. Oh, it's back.
Alright, so now that Lucas has absolutely nothing.
No.
What?
Stop fucking deleting it.
Wait, I didn't do that time. It was Bummy.
It's fucking gone now.
It's probably Arvind, dude.
It's not me.
It was the best one yet.
Anyway.
You can do another one because we're going to talk about anime next.
Oh, yeah, that happened.
Yeah, because we actually did something which you should have been a part of, Lucas.
No. Yo, but you destroyed my thing.
All right.
What are you doing over there? Why are you, like, getting in the mic for anime next?
I wasn't getting in the mic.
Is that how you prepare?
No, I was getting as close as possible. Oh, fuck. I got fucked. All right, can't.
Oh, what am I doing?
Yeah, just keep on. Just keep doing this. Let me get it over with.
What?
All right. So.
I think he's having, like, a separate conversation with someone else.
Yeah, who are you talking to?
So, anime next.
Yes, we did.
And I flew in, go to an anime con, which is kind of sad.
Yeah, that's dedication, dude. That used to be, like, anime man number zero.
Yeah, you should be anime man number zero now.
Well, I mean, it was fun. I met up with other friends when I went back home again.
Yeah, but who cares about those people?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I do.
Who
are you?
Flew like 2,000 miles to see like.
Wait, it's not 2,000 miles.
It's you're right. It's more like 3,000 miles.
Wait, let me check that. It's 1,000 miles.
So, like we said, 3,000 miles.
Well, I mean, Bumi's right. It was 2,000 miles because I had to fly here and back.
So how do you feel?
I feel like Bumi's right by technicality.
No, I was talking about how do you feel about you doing that.
I mean, it was all right, I guess. I mean, I need to get a credit card that lets me get frequent flyer miles.
That's what you learned from this entire thing?
Yeah.
Wait, what do you want me to learn? Man,
I don't know. Literally anything. You could have been like, I had a good time with my friends.
I said that
you
already.
You were like, yeah. But instead you're like...
You said
it was all right, I guess.
All right, okay.
And you followed that up with, huh, I need a better credit card.
Okay. So it was fun. Got to see some panels. Got a lot of posters. And now I think I'm going to buy some more because I have not buyer's remorse. The opposite of that. Like, I didn't
buy it. Sellers joy?
No. Like, I didn't buy it. So I'm sad.
Well, if what?
I mean, like, I regret not buying
what?
That poster.
Don't you mean you don't not regret buying the poster?
I don't know. It's too much math, dude.
All right. Well, you know what's not a lot of math?
What?
All the things that we saw at the place. Actually, no, there was no math. I thought about it. You know what the best part about that was, though?
What?
That one guy who was really mad about Ruby.
Oh, dude, that guy. The guy that was trying to talk to me, but, like, he just kind of scared me, and I couldn't say anything, because every time I tried saying something, he would jump in with, this is not right.
Yeah, okay. Well, you gotta give some context. So we were waiting in line for...
Can I...
No, shut up. You've talked enough.
It happened to me.
It happened to all of us, okay?
No, he was targeting me. I was the victim.
All right, well, I'm the setuper, and then you're the deliverer.
Okay, fine. We can do that compromise.
Okay.
I thought that was Jesus Christ.
I'm not. So we were waiting in line for the shitty Girls End panel, and...
Which was shit anyway.
And we left after, like, 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
But we were waiting in line, and there was this guy in front of us. Like, I don't remember what we were talking about, but eventually he got into a conversation with us. And then he started telling us how he was really unhappy with how some creators decide to just kill their characters off to make a point.
Wait, where's my part here?
You're gonna get to go! Hold on!
Yo, Shanks is becoming that person right now.
Yeah! And then he was talking about how he had problems with that in Ruby. But the funny thing is, he was talking to Shank about that and not any of the other people who really know anything about Ruby.
I was trying to tell him to talk to Raymond or you. That's why I brought you into the conversation. I was like, hey, this guy watches Ruby. Don't you want to talk to him? And then he was just like, nah. And he just kept on talking to me. And then I was like, that's a good opinion to have. I mean, I guess I don't know anything about the show except that it's like shitty and that there's cool music and yeah, and then he just kept on talking to me and then Ray kind of saved me there.
Yeah, Ray came in and actually said some things back, and then luckily the line decided to move when we got into the panel.
Yeah. I would have had to stay there, and I don't mind, but I had zero clue. I don't even know if Ruby is the name of a person in the show. Is Ruby the name of the person in the show?
It's the name of a person, but it's not spelled the same way as the show. It's spelled the normal way.
Oh, I always thought that Ruby was one of the girls from the show.
But it is one of the girls.
Yeah,
it's spelled differently. No, not in that spelled like that. All right, we're not going to get into why it's spelled like that. What are you... All right, even though I wasted more time explaining that than just explaining the thing. All right, what else did we do, though, at Anime Next?
Simon cracked my back in public.
Yeah, that always looks...
That was the highlight. That was the highlight of Anime Next.
I got charged $2.50 for cranberries.
Yeah, because you're just dumb.
Oh, man. That's just like daylight robbery, but...
No, it's not, because you had the option of asking how much it is.
Yeah, but like $2.50 for like cranberries is like...
If you ask for anything extra, it's always more than it's actually worth.
No, that makes sense. Like a dollar. I was expecting like a dollar, but this was $2.50. That's like what? 250% markup?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, they're all like that. You're the idiot for getting it in the first place.
I forget it.
As you're wont to do.
Yeah, you always gotta go have all your special needs whenever you order food, and then it always bites you in the ass.
It does. So, I got a lot of posters, and then my coworkers have told me now that it is unacceptable for a man to have unframed posters. Is that correct?
Think of it like this, right?
I mean, listen, like those frames cost, like if you want to get any sort of frames, they're like buying another poster.
Yeah, but it's like an anime poster. I don't want to put like an anime girl in a poster in a frame. Then I might just, I would feel even more weird.
That's what I was going to say. I was going to say, if there's anyone who comes in and judges that you don't have your poster in a frame, then they're just going to judge you that you have an anime poster. So you can't get out of it. So who cares?
Yeah, Arvinder, saving my life right there.
Dude, just buy more posters.
Yeah, just buy more posters.
I need to buy more. But
fill up those walls.
It was nice. I mean, Anime Next, I like it a lot.
Yeah, so Anime Next used to be held in Somerset, but then it got moved to Atlantic City, which means it was significantly less teenagery than it's been in the past couple of years.
So it was good.
Yeah, it was. I mean, I actually didn't never really minded the teenagers at the anime cons, but then again, every time we went to MAGFest, I was like, oh man, there's like no teenagers around here.
I used to think that Anime Next, the teenagers didn't bother me until this year when there were no teenagers, and I was like, wow, this is a huge difference.
It also helped that it was just a much bigger place, so not everyone was like right next to us, so we always had our own space.
That's true, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the dealer's room didn't feel like a fucking clusterfuck 24/7.
Yeah, you could actually look. And
do you remember the lines for Anime Next in Somerset? Remember standing out the door for pre-check for badges?
Well, we don't know if that might have still been happening. We got there like in the middle of the night where no one was picking up their badges. Yeah,
but you would think that like here, at least you could line up inside the AC.
Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah, last year I was outside for like an hour waiting to pick up my badge and it was like 85 degrees and I was dying.
It was really hot. It was so crappy.
So moved to a shittier place, but it ended up making it better.
So what else is new about Anime Next?
Well, I'm trying to think if there was anything else we did there.
That we just kind of bummed around.
That isn't just like, oh, we learned about animation and all that stuff.
Well, I found some good anime there in panels. Like I saw that one of the panels showed Turning Girl, that anime. It's like a small, like 4 or 5 episode one about like 28 or 29 year old working women who are like, one's like a fujoshi, one's trying to be an idol, like a fake idol. She sees herself as an idol. Another is like a band girl or something. I thought it was really good. So that was pretty good. And
what was that panel from?
That was from Otaku in Culture.
Oh, right. No, it's like a representation of otaku. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, no, that was really good, actually. I really enjoyed that one.
Oh, what about Japanese folklore?
Yeah, that one was so shit. Oh my god.
Like, me. Yeah. I get this.
So, like,
mine.
That one, the content wasn't even bad. It was just the presenter and the fact that he really, really liked himself and how much he liked Japan.
I don't know. I mean, I think that the content was kind of bad because, really? Well, I mean.
I thought it was fine.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, certain parts of the content were pretty cool. Like stuff like when you talked about the Suicide Forest, right? That's got a lot of pop culture appeal, right? Like it has a movie now. A Western.
Yeah, but
movie.
Just because it doesn't have pop culture things.
No, but I mean, it's like something that a lot of people can get, you know? It's like, I mean, I don't know much about Japanese folklore. It's not like I've been to Japan. So for me, like that was one thing that I thought was pretty cool. So I could get, but like everything else was like, you're just going there and seeing shrines. I guess that's cool. But
yeah,
like,
but the point was that those shrines and all of those things are such a big part of the Japanese stuff. That's
well, maybe
the point
he was
making.
Maybe he could have articulated it in a better way.
I don't know, man. I got it. But well, then again, but then again, I've like read a book about that for one of my classes in college.
Yeah, see, like, so maybe he was targeting a different audience. Because I know me, Simon, and Stephanie, I fell asleep.
Well, Simon, I mean, Simon falls asleep at anything. That doesn't count, okay?
But I'm pretty sure Simon fell asleep at like 3 of the panels that we went to.
Yeah.
So he doesn't count.
Yeah, but like, then I fell asleep.
All right, well, the worst part of that panel was just the fact that he was like, I did this. Okay.
That was so annoying.
It was all me. I did all of these things.
We should make a Kickstarter to go to Japan and then explore the culture and then present a panel about it.
I thought you were going to say we should make a Kickstarter to stop him from getting more things.
What? That's an asshole thing to do. He has a great idea.
No, Kickstopper, all right? Kickstopper. Yeah, Kickstopper.
So that's pretty much Anime Next.
Dude, we're like socializing war right now.
Yeah, and he was just like trying to sell his books. But yeah, that was Anime Next. We had a good time.
Yeah, it was nice.
Right. A lot, surprisingly long lines for 18 plus panels, though.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, that makes sense, right? Because it's in Atlantic City.
So,
yeah,
like, man, next time we go, we gotta make sure we line up for those.
Yeah, because, like, in the last years when we went to 18 plus, it was like, just walk right in, no problem. And now it was like, no, it's full. And we're like, what the fuck? That doesn't make any sense.
Well, that's because, like, people are probably gonna do stuff after. It's Atlantic City. So, like, the panels end at, like, 1, they probably go and, like, either drink or, like, gamble or something after for a couple of hours and then they go back to their room.
Yeah, that's
what I would do if I went with normal people.
Whoa. I mean, you could have still done that.
By myself? That's actually a problem.
You could have asked Ray to go with you.
No, he wouldn't have gone.
He wouldn't have gone. All right, next time he's around, we'll ask him if he would have gone gambling with you, and then we'll find out, okay?
All right, let's move on.
Do you want to say anything else from your week? Just don't take too long, because that was a
part of it. I tried playing Fallout again.
Why?
Why?
Because the DLC came out, right?
So you spent money on the DLC?
I got the season pass before.
Oh, this one. That's even worse.
No, the DLCs are usually really good for Fallout. Sometimes better than the actual game.
So like, how was
for
it?
Me, you know what's also better than like the entire game?
What?
Mods.
Yeah, but I don't got mods. I got a console.
Well, actually, PS4 mods are starting like next month.
Alright, then I can get those. But the thing is that gameplay is pretty clunky.
Yes.
And it makes me realize that because after playing the last PS4 game I played was Uncharted, right?
Yeah.
Before then I played Ratchet and Clank. And then before then I played that shitty game, Knights of Azure.
Yeah.
But all of those games had better control and better control schemes than the Fallout 4 did.
Yeah, that's why I when I played Fallout 3 the first time, I was like,
no,
what the fuck do people like this? This is trash.
No. The thing is that Fallout 3 was pretty good because the fighting and like that sort of gameplay was secondary to the RPG nature. There'd be stretches of land where you'd go without encountering enemies, right? In Fallout 4, it becomes more combat oriented, so it actually becomes a problem even for me, who can overlook those type of flaws, usually if there are other parts of the games that I enjoy, right?
Yeah. So you're telling me they made the combat better, but then they were like, hey, we made it better, so let's put more of it in there. And then that made it worse.
Yeah. It's like, I want to go around and talk to people and interact with people and do quests that I like, but all of these guys are like, they're caricatures. They're not even like, they don't feel like characters at all. I played Fallout 1 and 2 before too, and those guys actually feel more realistic. And they're literally just text boxes and a sprite.
Well, here's Fallout 4 continuing to disappoint.
Well, I still gotta play the DLC, right? Because I bought it, so.
You don't have to.
Well, I'm going to, because
that's
the DLC.
Some cost file stuff.
No, well, I mean, the DLC is supposed to be pretty good, so I'm interested in doing that. The parts that I like most about Fallout 3 were the DLC. And Fallout New Vegas, I like the DLC a lot too. Not as much as I like Fallout 3's DLC, but still to a decent extent. So maybe I like this one. And what else? Oh yeah, I started reading books again.
What? No one cares about books.
No, well, I mean, I'm reading a really cool one. It's called The Forever War.
You should stop reading it.
No, it's good. It's weird.
Do we need to get a Kickstarter going?
No, shut the fuck up. It's called an intervention.
All right, what are these about?
The Forever War?
Yeah.
So, basically, it's about... You remember Matthew McConaughey in Interstellar? Yeah. I dragged you to the movie.
Yeah, farmer astronaut.
Yeah, but imagine if, like instead of it being, like, in a shitty Earth, like, 100 years from now, it's, like, now, right? But, like, the same, like, wormhole and stuff existed. So, like, we still could send people to, like, far reaches of space, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in this book, like a soldier, like a group of soldiers go into this wormhole to go to the other side to try and establish military bases and like fight some sort of organism out in space. I haven't gone that far.
What is this gate?
Wait,
yeah,
listen.
Sounds like it.
No, this is like 1960s or 1970s or something, right?
What is actually, this? The thing Gates stole everything from?
Yeah, but actually the point is that eventually the guy comes back to Earth, right? After all this is done. But because of like some sort of weird time dilation and stuff, when he comes back, it's like millennia in the future and society's completely changed. And it's about, so and
he got
that's
destroyed?
Like the second part. No, that the second part is about how he adapts to the new society.
Oh, so he's about to get destroyed.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's like a military science fiction first, and then it becomes like some sort of like weird comedy and then what? Later on.
Okay.
It's one of the big big books of science fiction, apparently, like that, Dune. Then there's another one that I don't know. It's like three great pillars of science fiction.
All right. Well, enjoy continuing reading Not Interstellar. Bummy, did you do anything?
Let's see. No.
All right. So I finished Transistor.
Shit game.
All right, yo, why are you hating already? And that game has actually like a pretty cool ending because it did the thing that I always like where it's like you get to fight someone who's like you, but different.
But that's fine. But like, do you just pause time again and then issue commands?
Well, the other person also pauses time against you.
How does that work for a boss fight?
Because the boss will pause, you can't move, and then he will like issue commands, and then when it starts going again, you have to move slowly and try and get out of the way.
Damn, that sucks.
Yeah, but then you can hit him back. So, and then by that point, I actually had like really good combos going. So I was like doing like 1500 damage in one hit. I became pretty good at that game towards the end, probably because like I turned a lot of the limiters on, which meant I had like tons of experience points by the end of the game.
Oh, nice. I mean, I don't really care because it seems like a game that I would never play. I mean, even though I did play it and I didn't enjoy it.
All right. Yo, Bummy.
What?
You know how Shashank talks about all those things I don't really care about, but I still talk to him about it because that's like the nice thing to do and I'm not a rude ass piece of shit?
Yeah. I carried the conversation.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know what would be cool if like Shashank did that for us?
Okay. You want me to paint it?
That's asking way too much.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, Arbinder. So
that's
then,
asking way too much.
So, okay, Arbinder. So do you feel like you would play other games like this?
Actually, yeah, I would.
So
I actually had a really good time playing this. I just don't know if other games like this exist.
Yeah, that was my follow-up question. Are there other games like this?
I don't know.
Well, like, if you look at the new Final Fantasy, they have a pause mode where you can issue commands.
Yeah, I don't want to do that in Final Fantasy.
Well, now you can do that.
All right, but like, I want the game to be around that. I don't want there to be like an optional mode that does that.
Well, I mean, they saw how much you love this feature in the game.
Oh,
so
you're right.
Like,
they definitely.
Fuck, I gotta do this.
You're right.
Fuck, we gotta do this. The Meech wants.
Yeah,
this.
They were listening to the last podcast, which isn't even out yet because, you know, I haven't been doing the editing stuff. And
no,
they
no,
saw
fuck.
That I liked it. What? I'm busy.
No.
Busy with what?
Sucking other things. Dick? Yes.
No, dude, it's all right. You know why? Because what? I told them. It was me the whole time.
Oh, okay.
Well, I tweeted at Yosuke Matsuda, and I told him that you wanted this in the game, so that's why.
Were you just looking up who the director for Final Fantasy XV is?
I looked up Square Enix.
God.
Oh.
Damn.
I was looking at Square Enix CEO. All right.
Okay. Good job there. Good job. But the other thing I did was I got Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
Which is a shit game.
All right, so
should have gotten Overwatch.
All right, I'm going to say Overwatch. This. I'm just going to say
wait,
this.
We should have talked about Overwatch.
No, you talked. You talked about Overwatch in the last two podcasts. But here's what I'm going to say. If you liked Mirror's Edge 1, you're going to like Mirror's Edge. This Mirror's Edge. That's it.
You're going to like Mirror's Edge 2?
Well, wait, it's Mirror's Edge 2, not 2, like other reboot, prequel, whatever it is. You're going to like this game. Yeah, preboot. You're going to like the Mirror's Edge preboot. Because, like, it's actually, it's like, it plays, it has, like, all the cool stuff, but, like, less of the shitty stuff and more, like, actual things to do. Even though all the things to do are just, like, you know, get from this place to the other.
Go here. Package is broken.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much. But like, whatever. It's like I can have shitty thing, or I can just have like nothing. I don't mind the shitty thing, except for when they like start shit talking you in the middle of the run. Then they piss me off because some of those fuckers are assholes.
Look, Arvin, you just like lying.
There should be an option to like just drop the package.
You'd be like, "Fuck you!" Drop the package.
The
no. You should go all the way up to them, look them in the eye, drop the package. Yeah.
You know, there have been so many times where, like, I pretty much, like, I was sliding and I failed, but it doesn't stop the animation. So you slide to the other person. So you're standing in front of the person while they're telling you you failed. And I'm just like, why would you just take it? It's in my hand. Why would you tell me this?
Nah, I don't want it.
All right.
No, but you're a second late.
Because so it's broken, remember? You took too long.
Yeah, but when I hand it to them, when I get there at 0 seconds, and I hand it to them, then they accept it.
Well, then it's not broken. If you take too long, it breaks.
It makes no sense. But yeah, the best thing about that game, if there's any time in that game, if you're playing it and you decide to use the fast travel function, that means you don't like that game.
Well, right? I mean, that makes sense.
Like, that means you shouldn't be playing that game, because that game is getting from one place to another.
Is the map really small?
It's not that small. It starts off pretty small, but then it opens up, and it opens up to, like, different places. Like, at first you start out in the normal district, and then it opens up to the rich district, and then you open up to, like, the sewers, and then it opens up to the rich, rich district.
So just basic, like, different places, like, progression.
Yeah, but they all have, like, very different looks to them. It's like Far Cry?
Far Cry is, like, the same way.
I guess, but, like, in this game, you don't really have to, like, there is actually, like, I guess, taking towers. It's not really towers, but, like, where you break one of the other people's things, and then, like, there are less enemies around. I guess it's kind of like Far Cry in that way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But it's just dumb stuff, man.
Oh, yeah. Story's super shit, though.
Yeah, the game's just shit.
It's so bad. Like, no. The twist, I'm like, yeah, I already knew that. I know who that person is, because, like, you know.
Arvinder's dumb.
Yeah, and I'm dumb. Do you want to know what it was? I'll just say, because, like, if anyone cares, then they're an idiot.
We're not going to play this game.
Okay, yeah, no, I'm saying that if anyone happens to listen to this and they care, they're an idiot. So, in this game, it turns out that your sister, who you thought was dead, turns out to be, like, the adopted daughter of the bad guy, right? And I'm like, yeah, I know that. He's white. She's Asian. I knew that already. How do you not figure that out? And I'm, like, terrible when it comes to figuring out race. And I was able to figure it out.
Because that's such a shitty trope. That's literally... Bummy hasn't said anything because he's just, like, mind-boggled about how dumb this has got to be to get through the editors. They got to be like, yo, this is a nice idea for a game. Like, one paragraph. Yo, that's a game story.
Can you hear the editing incoming? Arvinder?
Hey.
Should I give you the timestamp?
No, it's okay. You know what I actually like? It's one of those things I like because I think it's stupid. Is like how all the runners have like that edgy aesthetic where they're like, yeah, we're cool. We're trying to look really cool and edgy, but they all look really stupid, right? And that's like one of the best parts of that game because they're trying to look cool, but they're failing.
Okay.
That's pretty much
intentional.
I don't think it was intentional, but like it's funny enough that I can accept it as like a good thing from the game. That's pretty much it. But that's that game. Only play it if you like the first Mirror's Edge. Don't play it if you.
What if you weren't alive when you the first Mirror's Edge? Or what if you never got a chance to play the first Mirror's Edge?
Then I suggest you ask someone who has, or you look at reviews from someone who you think has similar taste that you do.
Wait, the runners have cool clothes, Arvinder.
Yeah, they do, because they're trying to look really cool, but they don't really look cool.
Why? Oh, because they're just shitty runners.
Like, have you seen the other guy, Icarus? His name is Icarus. He wears like the hood.
How am I supposed to know? I don't even.
All right, just look up Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
I can't
Icarus.
Type.
All right, do it right now.
All right, fine. I'll type.
Oh, you could also use your phone.
Oh yeah, I see Icarus. That's who I was thinking was looking cool.
Yeah, no. First time I saw him, I'm like, look at this fucking tryhard.
I want that. I want that jacket.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I thought
maybe you like 7 years ago did, but like you currently no, you don't. Unless you're gonna get bullied again.
Yeah, you're right. But I do want that beanie that the other guy has.
All right, I don't know who you're talking about because the rest of the characters are like not very memorable.
Well, it's just a guy with the beanie. That's literally the only piece of clothing that is like noticeable.
All right, well,
everything else just looks like he's just a regular guy.
All right, well, that's it for what we did this week, and then we'll be right back with the news.
E3.
Well, yeah, E3 news. Lucas, bring us back.
Yeah, we're back, though.
Oh, you know what I realized? We didn't say who we were at the beginning of the podcast.
Why don't we just say that now and you can slice that in?
No, I'm not going to do that. Nah. But let's start off with the E3 news. And we'll go in order from when they happened for E3. So we're going to start off with the worst, which was EA.
Why is that worst?
Because, well, they started off with Titanfall 2, right? And that was actually pretty good. Like the people
are looking forward to that game.
Yeah, like the multiplayer looked really cool. And then the single player has Optimus Prime. And well, it doesn't actually have Optimus Prime, but it might as well have Optimus Prime.
What does your Titan have, like?
Yeah, he has like an AI and like it talks and stuff. Yeah.
There were like Transformers.
Does it give you sass?
No, he's like he's like Optimus Prime old man sounding.
Yeah, Optimus Prime doesn't give sass.
Yeah,
you give sass to Optimus Prime.
And then they showed pretty much nothing from Mass Effect Andromeda. They were just like, check it out, we're making the game. The only thing is that, like, I think the default Shepard, or not default, whatever Shepard person is, the main character is gonna be female instead of male this time.
Because Jennifer Hale is a voice actor?
Well, no, it's not gonna be Jennifer Hale because it's a different character.
Yeah, but I mean, because of the success of that?
Yeah, I'm assuming it's because of that. But like, if they don't have Jennifer Hale, then like, whatever. I don't care. Because Jennifer Hale was the thing. How are they going to get someone better than Jennifer Hale? Because no one exists.
Holly.
yeah, I don't know if they're going to have anyone.
Like, Israel girl, honest.
Yeah, yeah. So they didn't really show anything. They talked about all the Star Wars games they're doing, but like, they didn't have anything significant from any of them. So they just put them all together, and they just kind of said a little bit about each game, which pretty much might as well have been nothing, because we didn't really get anything out of it, at least anything new.
I got stuff out of it.
What'd you get out of it?
I didn't pay attention to this conference. I was just buzzing.
Exactly. The only interesting thing was when Amy Hennig came on and they showed like 3 seconds from her game, and you're like, and then you're like, oh, that's it? Okay. And then you stop caring.
No, wait, this is a new stuff. What new game is this?
Well, they're making several. They're making the next Battlefront.
No, the Amy Hennig game.
Hey, I'm going to go through all of them, you piece of fuck. Listen.
I'm a piece of fuck?
Yeah.
That doesn't even make any sense. A fuck is
the new Battlefront game, and they're making the Amy Hennig game, which is being done by Visceral. And then they're making the other third-person action game, which is being done by Respawn. But that's being headed by Stig Asmussen, whatever his last name is.
Stig Asmussen?
Yeah, Stig Asmussen, the guy who worked on like older God of War stuff.
Respawn made what game before?
Titanfall.
And Visceral made what game?
Dead Space.
Ah, that makes sense.
Yeah. And then there were sports things.
Yay!
Star Wars?
No, at the EA press conference. There were sports things that I don't give a shit about, really, so...
Wait, I like sports.
We can just skip those.
Wait, we gotta talk about the sports.
Alright, here's what I'll say. The FIFA has, like, a story mode, which will hopefully be stupid enough to make me care.
Like the NBA one?
Yes.
Well, I mean, they do a pretty good job with the story modes in most of those games.
I don't know, man. Yeah, I know. I'm sure the rest of it will be fine, but like
people say, like, the fact is that 20 years ago, you'd probably be like, the fuck? A sports game with, like, a story mode? Because people just would sit down and play the game.
Yeah.
Like, in, like, 2007.
Like, the best I can hope for is, like, a good sports movie type of thing, and that's about it.
Well, you could just do what my brother does and watch the YouTube clips of all the cutscenes.
All right, well,
but they're using a new engine for these sports games.
Yeah, they're using the Battlefield engine.
So, which is good, right?
Yeah, that is pretty good, which means it'll have really good sound.
It'll have really good what?
Sound.
Sound?
Yes.
But the thing is that, like...
Wait, so then, can we, like, destroy, like, the stadium?
I mean, maybe you can recreate, like, Batman
Revolution. Yeah, but...
Returns.
I don't know, man. There's just, like, all these games, it's like, oh, it's slightly better than the last one.
Ooh. No, that's actually not true. Because, like, I play these games, right? And people make a big deal about it only being slightly better than the last one. But those minor changes for simulation-based games like racing games, sports games, which I play both of them, make a huge difference. Like, if you imagine if, like, if there's a Dark Souls each year or, like, an ARPG each year and they...
That's like a terrible idea.
No, but listen, they tune the hitboxes every single time. or and like other mechanics of the game so that it was perfect. It was more perfect every single year. People who are really fanatics of those simulation genres that want it exactly precise would buy those games. But the thing is, that's just how the main crowd is for sports and racing games. They want it as close to the real product as they can get. That's why you don't have games that like it used to be in football games where you could just keep the sprint button down and just keep running back and forth and not lose speed. But now they've they have like turf mechanics and everything. They add all those things in and people care about them. The people that care about them are the people that buy the game, the sports players. So
I don't think so.
I mean, I care
about people buy them because they go, listen, Madden, like, let's play.
Well, I mean, yeah. I can, no, but like I care about
it's more for the social aspect. Like people don't go out and buy Arma 3 because it's realistic, right? Or I mean,
well, yeah. Look, I'm not saying that people don't buy it because it's a new Madden, because the rosters are updated. The thing is that, like, you could say the same argument about, like, Call of Duty or something, that people buy the same thing every year.
Yeah, and that's true.
No,
Call of Duty games, Call of Duty games were not very different for many years.
Yes, but what I'm saying is that I feel like these games, I can see that incremental change. To most players, maybe they don't like care about it, but a lot of people do. A lot of people that don't buy like every Madden, but they like me, I buy every other Madden.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's it, if they release one every 2 years, then it'd be more noticeable. But if it's like, hey, we changed like this tiny little thing,
and
that's
yeah, it. Yeah, but like,
and it's like still, every single year, and that's it.
But
I'm not saying that it's if other people are okay with it, that's fine for them. I'm just saying I think that's kind of silly.
But I guess I still don't recognize it as a valid complaint for people who don't play the game. I mean, like, because then they have no input on like how it might be different. Know what I mean?
Yeah,
they have no bearing on like exactly like.
No, the only thing is, it's like I watch these things every single year, and I feel like they say the same thing every single year. Like, you can control the ball much better now.
No, you don't control
the
ball.
Do you see how he's moving? No, I'm saying like you have the FIFA games where they're like you can pass
Madden ball mode.
No, because hey, Madden's not the only sports game, okay? There are other sports games.
No, in which game are you the ball?
No, I'm not saying you're the ball. I'm saying you have control over the ball. Isn't that the whole point of these games where you have balls? You want to have control over ball?
No, so
the point of this game is that you have balls.
And every time they say you can pass the ball, and
no, some
it's
like,
much better now.
So for me, sometimes when I'm playing FIFA, right, the mechanics might change so drastically between one game to the next that this is anecdotal, right? Because this is just me, and I don't know why this is the case. But for like the last ones, I'll have to change up my style because the running mechanics might be different. The players, the ratings are different, and they might have more ratings and more like statistics that like they always have like ratings, right? That depend on like the situation. Like some players in like FIFA can run faster in like without the ball versus with the ball compared to other guys, whereas other people might dribble faster, and like other people like
yeah, but all those things can be done. You don't have to create a whole new game. You can like
no,
you know,
but the thing
update
is, they
the
change,
game
they but they change like the engine and how it works around it some a lot of the time.
I don't know, man. I don't see I understand it's if weird. People like it. I'm just saying that like there are other ways of doing it, so them saying that this is the better way, it's not necessarily true.
I mean, man, I have okay. This is enough.
EA.
No, there was one more thing with the Battlefield thing, because after the Battlefield, all this thing was over, they had, like, members of the community, and by community, I mean they just got a bunch of celebrities, to play Battlefield 1 64 player map.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And, oh, dude, the Snoop.
And it was just, like, everyone was just really high, because, like,
so awkward.
There was so, like, other people that were there, they were, like, the place, it was just smoke. There were people there, like other people that were there that weren't like the celebrities. They were just invited to go there, and they came back there like, all right, I'm pretty sure I got like high just from being in that room because
of
how
much
it was.
Where like they walked out of the back room and they were all just coughing.
and Snoop Dogg was like, don't worry, I got my secret weapon. All right, that was EA. Now, next up was Bethesda, which was a lot shorter than the other ones. The big thing they showed off was the new Dishonored game.
Not gonna lie.
Ooh.
Bummy, did you like the first Dishonored game, right?
Yeah, it was all right.
Well, the game was shitty, man.
Nah, you're just bad.
It was
like great.
I played an hour and was like, this sucks.
The weird thing.
Three of us played an hour.
No, I played the game and I was like, this is a pretty good game. I don't want to play it, and that's what. That's it.
I opened up the game and I was like, this would be really fun if I knew how to play this game. Like, if I was good at this game, then I could just zoom around everywhere and kill people. But I know that, like, I know I can't do that shit, and I'm too shitty to play stealth. So I don't want to play this game. It just makes me feel sad.
They showed off this really cool thing. It reminded me of, like, Prince of Persia, where you have this item where you're in an area and you can change the time. So that way you can come there when it's like populated with guards and stuff, or you can come in when it's like all dilapidated and like broken down and stuff. But the cool thing is you can like lift up the device and it shows you what's happening in the other time period. So you can like sneak up behind guys from the other time period.
So it's like Warrior Within.
Yeah, but like actually good.
Warrior Within was good.
I mean, I liked that game, but I don't know if it was good.
It was good, man. For PS2 era, that was pretty good. And that Godsmack soundtrack.
Alright, calm down there. They showed off Prey, which is a reboot of a series that only had one game. There was another game called Prey that came out, right? But this game is also just called Prey, and there was never a Prey 2.
Well, I guess
this is like a sequel and a reboot.
It's not a sequel, though, because this has nothing to do with the old Prey.
So it's just a reboot?
It's just a reboot. And
so they prayed for a reboot?
Well, what seems like happened here, they were like, all right, we got a couple of cool mechanics that we can put into a game. And then Bethesda was like, we have the Prey license. You guys want that name? And they're like, all right, yeah, sure, we'll take it. Because it's, you know, easier for marketing.
So, the studio that made Dishonored, Arkane, they're working on both Dishonored 2 and Prey at the same time.
Sure.
So maybe it might just be, like, the same engine and stuff.
I guess. Because, like, the new Prey game seems like more of a survival horror thing. And Dishonored
Prey?
But, and then Dishonored is, like, you know, stealth and stuff. So.
Splinter Cell.
Yeah. They also showed off the new
Splinter
Quake.
Cell?
No, the new Quake, which is called Quake Champions. And it looks like it's going to be a hero shooter.
So. Oh, dear.
More Overwatch stuff.
This is just going to get saturated before it even becomes saturated.
Well, they've been working on this game for before Overwatch stuff, right?
Overwatch has like 10 million players now, right?
Yeah,
that's because like, but we already have like Battleborn, which isn't a hero shooter.
But yeah, Battleborn also
Battleborn's like, it's like a non-player right now.
Yeah, because no one's playing that game, so yeah, even if like, it exists, what, like, it doesn't matter.
Three players?
Might as
Yo,
well
shut
be
up.
Playing.
Don't be mean.
It's
Don't
the truth.
Seriously. So, you know, like a couple of weeks ago, we talked about how Blizzard was banning like 3,000 people.
Yeah.
That's more than half of the like players that are currently playing right now on Battleborn.
There was another one where they said more people playing Call of Duty World at War at one point than Battleborn. So they're having a tough time over there. They also showed off the Skyrim remaster for PlayStation 4, Xbox One.
Why?
The remaster?
Because
people
like
will buy it.
Yeah. I mean,
They said. They said, "What are the good mods that were on the PC?"
Seriously,
let's just put that into the game.
So the truck mod is gonna come in?
No, you idiot! No, there might be
Macho Man Randy Savage.
There might be because the mod stuff is also coming to Skyrim. This new Skyrim now for consoles.
Great.
Yeah. And I think that was really it. There was something about Fallout 4 in VR, but you know, whatever. Next up was Microsoft, and they started with Gears of War 4, and that's about all I care about for Gears of War 4.
Like Gears of War 4.
Yo, what about the new Xbox?
Yeah, that's what I was just gonna say. So
wait, can we talk about Gears of War 4?
All right, what do you have to say?
It's a good game. It looks nice, and I remember there was controversy recently.
It looks nice.
I remember there was controversy that like the main characters in the game look like just like. You know how like a lot of JRPGs are like high school teenagers and stuff?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so, but like these were like hipster kids.
Yeah, that's because they are like hipster kids. They're like really young.
Yeah, and so there was so much anger over this is crap. I don't want to play as a hipster.
The main male character is Marcus Phoenix's son, so he's obviously pretty young. Otherwise, Marcus Phoenix would be like old as fuck.
Yeah,
and you can't have him that old.
I thought that was hilarious that people were so mad about playing as hipsters.
Well, you know how people are stupid. But the new Xbox One, the Xbox One S, is going to be 40% smaller than the current Xbox. It's going to be for $300. The other cool thing is that they're going to have new Xbox One controllers now with Bluetooth. So you don't have to buy the dongle thing if you want to play wireless on PC now.
Well, you still need to buy a Bluetooth. That's still a dongle.
Yeah, no, but I'm saying that, like, you can use that for other things. The dongle can only be used for the Xbox One controller.
Okay.
Yeah. And you can also order custom Xbox One controllers now, so you can put in all the shitty colors and, like, write down dumb things on your controller.
Yeah, and engrave it.
Yeah, engrave it. Yeah.
Gamer tag.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I mean, that's, like, useful for some people, I guess.
Yeah, XX360 no scope headshot XX.
Exactly.
420.
There was kind of some stuff from Sea of Thieves, which is like the pirate game where you have like teams of four people.
Yeah, it looks like an MMO kind of.
Yeah, I don't really know what's going on with that game. I just know that you can have a team of four people and you can crew a ship together.
When my friend linked me this trailer for this game, because I didn't see this one, I guess I looked over it. It looked cool, but it was shitty. Like, I would never want to play that game. It just looked like I was, like, everybody just works around a ship. Like, has to go and do shit around the ship. If I wanted to do that, I could just do chores at home.
No, but it's like Guns of Icarus or whatever.
But Guns of Icarus is cool because it's, like, steampunk and you're fighting other ships in the air. This is kind of
I don't know, man.
Slow.
Pirates are kind of pretty cool. I like pirates more than steampunk shit.
Yeah,
shit.
Wait, relax. You're talking to one of the biggest One Piece fans in the world.
Yeah, you can be like, yeah, One Piece, yeah, I'm Luffy,
yeah, but for real, it's like, it didn't seem to move that fast. In Guns of Icarus, I do get the feeling, like, at least in that game, when we saw it at, like, PAX and stuff, that's the only time I've actually been really introduced to that game, and the ships were moving, and it seemed like everybody was doing something, but it seemed like stuff was happening.
Right, but Guns of Icarus is much more complete than this, so hopefully...
That is true. There's gonna be
more done, but I like the idea of this game, I just don't know if it'll be that fun.
Yeah,
but I mean, it's being developed by Rare, right?
Yeah, but like, you know, this is like the shell of Rare. This is
Viva Pinata.
No. This is the Rare that made all the Kinect games. Viva Pinata came out in like 2005 or 2006 or whatever. After that, they just made a bunch of Kinect games and that's it.
Whoa.
Yeah, so we don't know if they'll be good. Scalebound from Platinum was there, and the demo they showed off, I just didn't think was that great, because it was like, you know, you find a giant thing. You were fighting a giant thing, and it's like, there wasn't really much that he was doing. He sometimes got on his dragon, fired some shots, and then he would fire the bow, which looked like it wasn't doing anything. And I'm just like, all right, the other stuff you've shown looked much better than this.
It looked really choppy, and it looked really, really early on. I feel like it will be better. It's a good idea. And I really like Dragon games. I really wanted Lair to be good. Lair was shit. I really want this to be good. Hope this is not shit.
Hey, you can play or you can ride a dragon in Drakengard games.
But Drakengard is shit.
Yes, I know. That's why I realized
why
that if you
all the dragon
no, because if you get on a dragon, it makes it shitty. Don't get on dragons. That's it. That's what I've learned.
Instead, just play Overwatch, and then you could summon the dragon.
Yeah, there you go. Recore was there. Recore was there, and that's the game that's being made by Keiji Inafune and like some Metroid Prime people.
Keiji Inafune of Mighty No. 9 fame?
Well, of Mega Man fame. But, like, Mighty No. 9 is the current thing.
do you guys see the trailer?
It looks so shitty.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Is
that the one with the narrator?
Yeah. The devs of the game also saw that, and they were like, what the fuck is this? why is this a trailer for our goddamn game, pretty much.
People probably looked at that and was like, we do not want to buy that game now. Yeah.
Well, ReCore, you have like your little robot buddy, which can get into other robot buddies, and then he can be different robot buddies.
But Armature, what games have they made?
I don't know.
Alright, let me just look real
quick. Okay. Are you looking?
Yeah, I'm looking. So, they made Arkham Origins Blackgate. Okay. They made Injustice Among Us for the PS Vita. They made a lot of PS Vita games. Oh. They made Metal Gear Solid HD Collection for the PS Vita. And they made the PS Vita. And they made the Borderlands Handsome Jack Collection.
Oh.
They're a really good studio.
Oh, their great studio, yeah.
Yeah, I can tell you that for a fact that their games are really good. Their ports are at least very good. So, man, why is it Xbox One PC exclusive? This is like one of the best PS Vita studios there is.
Hey, man, they gotta get work. Final Fantasy 15 was there. They showed off a boss fight, which looked terrible. I think something went wrong with their live demo, and the boss wasn't doing something he was supposed to be doing.
Uh-oh. So, what about the car, though? Did they show off the car?
No, that was in a different one. We'll get to that in a little bit. They showed
the hair.
Yeah, they showed off Dead Rising 4, which is going to have Frank West again, which is pretty good, because, you know, Frank West is the best character in that game, because, you know, Dead Rising, the first one, and Case Zero are the only good Dead Rising games, you know. Do you guys, like, ever even play Dead Rising?
Nope.
I don't even know.
Wait, Dead Rising 2 is really good.
No, but did you play Dead Rising 1?
No.
Oh, well then there you go.
Yo, Frank, something.
Frank West? Yeah, but you didn't play as Frank West in Dead Rising 2. You played as the guy with the daughter.
Yeah, I don't know his name. But yeah. It's Ombrex, dude.
I don't care about that guy. I want Frank West. And that's what we're getting.
Orange juice.
I don't even know who this guy is. Can we just skip that, dude?
Wait, what about orange juice? Oh, the orange juice? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, orange juice. Yeah. Always have the orange juice. Forza Horizon 3 was there. The really cool thing about that game was that you can play with like other people, but when you get called into someone's world, a helicopter comes, picks up your car, and drops you off in the other person's world.
That's so cool.
Like, that's something that doesn't need to be in the game, but they just put it in. They're like, yeah, fuck it, we can do it. Yeah, go ahead, put it in. Halo Wars 2.
This is the first one, like, shitty.
I don't know. This is another one.
For the RTS fans in Korea?
Yeah. Now they're
oh, God.
So, they're making Gwent from The Witcher just its own game.
Do you remember the mod for The Witcher where this guy just replaced every single encounter with a game of Gwent? Because the moment you hit like an enemy, it would just trigger a game of Gwent.
All right, well, I guess they're just actually making that now, because this does actually have single player like content, like a story mode.
Oh, wow.
So we'll see what that's about.
They could have just rolled this off into like Hearthstone or something, and people would still play it.
Yeah. Tekken 7 was there.
Wow.
Lucas? Lucas!
Oh, what's up?
Tekken 7, story mode. You don't want to see story mode Akuma and Heihachi fights?
No. Wait, I thought Tekken, why is it coming to Xbox One? And
no, this was them saying that it's coming to Xbox One. Like, this is the first place they said it's also coming to Xbox One.
Okay.
Yeah, it's also coming to PS4, though. But, like, this is them saying that it's coming there. And, yeah, you excited for the story mode?
No.
Why not?
I am. Wait, I'm so excited.
Wait, why aren't you excited for the story mode? You don't want to find out what happens to all those characters you love?
No.
Heihachi?
Like Heihachi and Kazuya?
Well, they went into Dark Souls, so it's fine.
Oh, okay. All right, so that's it for Microsoft. Well, there was actually more, but I just kept a bunch of it.
What about the Division?
Yeah, DLC, no, shut up. No one cares. Okay, so Ubisoft press conference.
Nobody plays that game anymore.
Wait, hold on. Well, I was about to read this wrong. Ghost Recon Wildlands. It's like Metal Gear Solid 5, but you can play co-op.
Wildlands?
Yeah. It's a new Ghost Recon game. And, like, it's the same, like, here's, like, an enemy base type of thing. You can plan out how you want to go attack it, like, in Metal Gear Solid 5. But you can also play with other people now. Like, you can play with up to 3 other people. That's it. No one's interested?
Not really.
All right. I thought, all right, that's it. Watch Dogs 2. It's Watch Dogs, but now in San Francisco.
So can we, like, actually hack everything except, like...
Okay, even if they say you can hack everything, I don't believe them until the game comes out. You probably can't hack everything. Like, we'll see.
Like, six things you could hack?
Yeah, so the problem with, like, the first Watch Dogs, it was like, oh, okay, so they were like, yo, this is, like, a cool hacking game. Why am I just shooting guys? Where's the hacking? And, like, that's what a lot of people didn't like. This has, like, more parkour shit going on because they were like, you know, we have Assassin's Creed. We can make that happen. And then they were just like, all right, hopefully they put in more, like, I just want to see punch guys, hack shit, and parkour. Like, that's more important than shoot.
Cause
that's
not fun. Mean, why would the guy punch? He's a hacker. He probably doesn't have the, like...
Whoa. If you can, like, do parkour and shit, I'm pretty sure you can punch people.
He's probably skinny.
No, he hacks people so that they punch themselves.
Okay,
all right. See, that works.
Okay, all right, yeah, yes. And they showed off a lot of South Park Fractured Butthole, and...
get it.
And it just...
Yeah, this sounds like a dumb Ratchet and Clank name.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Of your arsenal.
Hey, those Ratchet and Clank names were great. It's really too bad they stopped using them, okay? And yeah, this
Ratchet and Clank 4
play. I think I'll probably like get this game because I like South Park, and I didn't play the Stick of Truth, but you get Stick of Truth if you pre-order this game. So you know, I guess I'll finally play them. And
maybe
that's
me
it.
Too. Who knows? Right,
we'll find out. For Honor was there showing off their story campaign. So now,
what is that supposed to be?
For Honor, that's the game, the melee or third person chivalry type of thing.
It's like Vikings versus Samurais.
It's Vikings, Samurais, and Knights. And I think there is a different like story mode for each of those, but I'm not sure. It looks really cool. Or at least I think it looks really cool.
Right. It looks all right.
Yeah.
You didn't talk about the open world sports game, Steep.
Oh, that's what that was? Okay, so I saw that game. I had no idea it had a name. Because I just saw like a bunch of shit happening. And I'm like, what the fuck is this game?
It's
just
weird, like, right?
It's like GoPro. World. It's GoPro in the mountains. That's the game. You ski and you can, what's that called? Where you glide with the wingsuit. And
you mean
paragliding?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's
it's called wingsuiting.
Wingsuiting, okay, wingsuiting. Yeah. And like and you have the
like a VR game.
Yeah, and you just have like the GoPro type of camera the entire time. It looks pretty interesting, but like okay, it's interesting mostly because they haven't made games like this really. Like they haven't done.
Cool. It's cool because it also looks good.
Yeah, like it just looks like it's a bunch of dudes like actually doing the thing because they don't have to show faces or anything. So it actually just looks like they're doing the thing.
Yeah, it might be their version of an easy to port to VR game.
I'm waiting for a Steep montage on YouTube.
Yeah, we'll probably see a lot of those, but I think that was all the important
I'm waiting for a ski free from Ubisoft.
Let's move on to Sony. They started off with God of War, or the new God of War, which is called God of War.
You literally just like skip like so much.
Okay, stuff. So which of those things do you care about?
The Assassin's Creed movie.
Okay, that's what I thought. Now, God of War, it's just like you play as Kratos, but like you're a bad parent.
Wait, this behind the camera look for the third person, it's like they took that out of a Naughty Dog engine.
Yeah, it looks like they're making it like a lot of the open world stuff seems like it's what like Tomb Raider does, and they took some of the combat stuff from Dark Souls.
Yeah, so it's like the best of everything.
Yeah, it actually made me interested because when I first heard about this, I didn't care about this God of War game.
But you play God of War.
I played every single one. I didn't care about this until they showed off that they're actually doing something new.
I can't even play God of War because it's too simple combat. It's like square, 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 square.
Well,
square,
I always
square,
play square, on like the hardest difficulty so you die in like 2 hits.
Wow.
So that way I can be like, wow.
Oh,
I'm really
so you mean
good.
Square, 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 triangle?
No. That's
and
not
then
it.
Some circle.
No. It's way easier than that. This is how you do it. You go Square, square, triangle, roll. Square, square, triangle, roll. Square, square, triangle, roll.
That's so how easy. You win. And it's so easy because don't they map one of the analog sticks to roll anyway?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
automatically?
Yeah, yeah.
So you don't even have to press a button to roll.
Because you didn't have camera control in God of War games. The right analog stick was used for rolling and stuff. But this, it looks a lot more like Dark Souls-y. So hopefully
that's
it'll be cool.
That's good.
Yeah. The Kojima game.
Death Stranding or something?
Naked yeah. man holding a baby.
This is like, they took my baby away.
Not just any naked man, it's yeah. Norman Reedus.
Yeah.
Yo, Norman Reedus looks like a college professor I used to have. And yeah, he does. And then what? And I forgot about that until I saw this trailer. And then I started wondering, why is Dr. Stone in this game? And then I realized it was the guy from Walking Dead.
Yeah.
Do you think it's actually going to be good?
The game? Here's the thing. So this is Kojima Unleashed, right?
It's going to be like George Lucas Unleashed, man.
Yeah. Like, I feel like it's going to be like, all right, I need like $200 million. And they'll be like, okay. And then it's like, no one's buying this game. We'll see. Because I don't know if, like, there's literally no one to stop him from doing something if he won't just make it too much. So we'll see. They showed off Final Fantasy 15 there, and they showed the VR stuff where, like, there's, like, a little thing where you can play as Prompto because he's the shooty guy. You can, like, play mission with him.
You can play as Prompto.
And there's also another one where he's riding in the car with Cindy. And a lot of people were talking about how, because they had this VR thing at E3, and some of the people who were like in line, they were looking at how all the guys were just like getting really close to Cindy while she was sitting right next to them, like not even thinking about the fact that they were in public, just getting right in there, getting a real close look.
I mean, what did they expect would happen?
I guess. They even had, like, one of the VR porn companies was at E3, too, so this is just what's going to happen. Yeah.
It's already begun.
Yeah. More Horizon Zero Dawn. Just another gameplay demo. Looks good. Apparently, it's actually a lot more of an RPG than it seemed like earlier.
This game looks amazing. And this game looks like exactly what I want.
Like it has Mass Effect dialogue wheels and everything.
Perfect.
Yeah. And
as long as it doesn't got crafting, then I'll be like, this is the greatest.
It might have crafting. It seems
but
like
it can't be. It can't be. But it can't be like really hard crafting. But otherwise, I pretty much love this game because it has that plot points that I love. A strong female lead. Post-future apocalyptic stuff, like future past type thing.
Well, this is like post-apocalyptic.
Yeah, which is amazing. And it's like everything I ever want from any story ever. This is like the sci-fi I live for.
All right, looks like we're just going to move on before you actually jizz in your pants.
I am jizzing.
Do you guys care about the David Cage game? Can we just not?
Not really.
Okay, good.
I mean,
Shut up. Resident Evil 7.
Oh, shit.
So...
Is it actually good?
Well, it's going to be...
I heard it was first person now, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's first person now, and you can play the entire game in VR if you want.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And you're trying to wear all the hats.
And it's going way back to the more horror than action stuff now. So it's not going to be like Resident Evil 6, where it's just an action game without any horror in it. This is like... a lot of people say that they took a lot of stuff from PT, and they're doing that. Days Gone, which is the... Oh, Shank, we probably care about this, right? You care about this? You like Sony Ben because of the Uncharted game? This is the biker zombie game.
Well, I don't really like zombies, but I love bikers. So
it's like Last of Us, but with bikers. Days Gone. And they have the zombies from the DayZ. What's that? No, not DayZ. World War Z movie, where like they move as like a huge pack instead of just like single zombies and stuff. I don't know.
Does look like The Last of Us.
Yeah, it actually looks pretty interesting. I just hope that you do less shooting than you do in that demo they showed off.
It looks like some Sony executive was like 2 years ago or 3 years ago, well, people like zombies. Yeah. People like Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah.
And Last of Us sold well. Yeah. Let's just put them all together.
Yeah, pretty much. This game could be good. I'm just not sure yet. We'll have to wait and see.
Sony is a good developer.
Yeah.
Like, it's a good studio. So I think that I would guess that it would be good, but I don't know.
The new Call of Duty game in space. It's in space, guys. Did you know that it was in space?
Does it look good?
It actually looks
all right. Wait, I like it.
It actually looks all right, though.
It looks really good.
Yeah,
I don't even like Call of Duty, but I like this game because it's like, it's everything that I want from, like, I like sci-fi stuff. I like games where, I like the fact that you could shoot in space. That sounds super fun.
Even though it makes no sense. Yeah,
it doesn't make sense, but that's like, that's literally like the coolest thing ever.
Yeah, so when this demo started off, I didn't know it was Call of Duty. Like, that's how different, like the style, the art style and stuff is. They're actually making something different, so.
I don't know why people are mad. Like, this game actually.
Because it's Call of Duty. People get mad at Call of Duty. That's just a thing people do, okay? You have to accept that, man.
I am accepting that. It just
and there's Insomniac's making Caramel us
said his only game. Why you have to be mad?
Insomniac's making a Spider-Man game.
Yo, quick thing on this. Before, the rumors were that it was Sucker Punch.
Yeah.
And I didn't like it because of that. But now, because it's Insomniac, I think it'll be really good. Because Insomniac is a better developer, and they do a wider range of games.
The thing is, like, Sucker Punch doesn't really do, like, as much moving around stuff. I mean, the Infamous games had some interesting stuff, but, like, Insomniac is a lot better at doing...
Insomniac is one of the better developers, I feel. Like, all their games have been fun.
Although, I've liked the Sucker Punch games more, but I still think that Insomniac is probably going to be better for this. Plus, it seems like this is just part of the deal where Sony gave the movie stuff back to Marvel. I guess part of that was, like, they're like, all right, well, we're going to make a game, and it's going to be PS4 only.
Yeah, that's probably the case. Yeah. Because Marvel, what's Disney Games going to do? Make Skylanders?
Hey, Disney, no. Disney stuff is shut down now, remember?
Yeah, I know. That's why they're probably going to like Skylanders, Spider-Man.
All right, well, that was it for Sony. There's other stuff, but, you know, usual.
Wait. Care.
What?
Wait, we're not going to talk about VR?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't care. there's nothing interesting on those. It's just like, here's the experience.
Yeah.
I don't care about that.
Yeah, I know you don't. That's why I brought it up. You can make your voice higher. I can make my voice higher too.
What do you have to say? This takes longer. Okay, all right. Great.
I just like fucking with you.
Let's move on to the best game from the show, which is the new Legend of Zelda.
That Breath is of the opinion, Wild. But I might actually buy an NX just for this game. And but it's not the best game at the show.
It was the best game at the show, right? And it's Zelda, and it's open world, and it looks amazing.
Looks fun. It looks fun. For a person who doesn't like Nintendo.
You look at that game, you're like, wait,
it almost has like a Shadow of the Colossus vibe.
Yeah, when I saw it, I was like, wait, am I watching an anime?
I like the art style a lot. It reminds me of like the GameCube one.
The best one?
Wind Waker?
Wind Waker?
Yeah.
It looks like a mixture of like the Wind Waker and like the other like more realistic 3D looking ones.
Yeah, but like this is more Wind Waker than the other
ones. Yeah, that's why I like this one a lot. Because it's stylish and it's simple, but it's still fun. There's a lot of things to do, at least from what I saw the trailer of. I might buy an NX. Fuck you, Nintendo.
Don't be mad because you want to play their games. So, the other weird thing that this game, you know how we were all like, oh, we will probably be able to play as female Link and stuff? Well, you can't. And some people asked Nintendo about why you can't. And they gave some of the most bullshit answers. Because, like, all they had to say was, we didn't want to. But they had to, like, make up some dumb shit where you're just, like, you're just making this shit up. Where he said, he was like, well, you know how there's, like, there's a Triforce in the game, right? And, like, it's made up of Zelda, Ganon, and Link. If Link was a female, the balance would be thrown off. What balance?
Ganondorf is asexual?
What balance? Yeah. What do you mean balance? And then they said, well, if we were to have a female playable characters, we would want to have it be Zelda. But then what would Link do in the game?
Yeah, I want to see a game where, like, Link gets captured in Zelda.
Yeah, the answer is, like, fucking make the story. And then you tell us what we will do. Yeah, like, Luke can do anything. Don't say, well, we don't know what to do. Because you can do other things, and it's not, like, that hard to figure out. Man, what a bunch of fucking fucks. Or, you know, here's an idea. I got this crazy idea. Why don't you make Link and Zelda playable?
Wait, so...
That's too much work, dude.
Which games can you play as Zelda in, anyway?
Hyrule Warriors?
Smash?
Any other ones?
Not in any...
Wait, not even, like, briefly where you don't do anything with it?
No, I don't think so.
Because, like, you know, Peach has been playable. Come on.
They're thinking of making one.
They're thinking of making what?
A Sheik spinoff.
They are?
Yeah, there was a source for that.
Is this one of those rumor things that we don't talk about?
No, I'll go and get the source.
Shashank, is this one of the sources that cause you to be wrong every time you enter an argument?
I mean, it's a rumor, and it's like...
Wait.
Time out. I said it was a rumor, but it's Shigeru Miyamoto.
What, he's spreading the rumor?
Yeah.
What do you mean he's making the rumor?
He's the one who's talking about it.
Oh, that probably means like he typed some cryptic shit on Twitter or something. Alright, that's more credible than your average rumor.
Wait, Miyamoto knows how to use Twitter?
Fucking 2016, dude.
I mean, it's Nintendo. It's Nintendo.
But one thing I want to ask before I leave is that, and some Nintendo news, is that some reports that came out today and something that like that Red Nintendo said was like, the NX is not trying to get some teraflops in up here, and they don't care about the specs and shit. That was wrong. Do you think that they still haven't learned?
No.
That they won't learn?
They've never learned.
Do you think
learning?
Do you think that, like,
it's a company again? Run by a bunch of old people.
Do you think they'll get fucked yet again?
Maybe. It really just depends on if, like, they make a lot of good games and stuff or not.
I don't know.
Like, the big problem with the Wii U was that everyone was confused as to what the fuck the Wii U was. They were like, what is that, like an add-on to the Wii?
And
like, no one even knew that it was a new console also.
I guess.
And
but
no,
like,
good games came out for it for like a really long time.
I guess, but like, the other consoles got so much good publicity compared to that.
Yeah,
I
because mean, they had like a bunch of games Wii that people Wii wanted Wii to play.
The people who are on the fence... We're probably like, no, I'm not going to get it. A lot of the casual gaming crowd might not want that anymore.
Yeah, because they're like, wait, I can play all of these games here, but I can only play a couple of games here? Why don't I just get all the games?
So then who's going to get an NX if, like...
I don't know. No one? Me?
I'll probably get one, but, like, that's also because I got a lot of disposable income compared to the average video games consumer.
Maybe? I don't know, because, like, average video game consumer is pretty old nowadays.
I don't know, but, like, so the point is that, like, it's probably coming out this season, right? Because Ubisoft was saying that they're going to release a game early next year.
NX is coming out in March 2017.
Okay, so it's going to come out. That's a weird time. But
yeah, they probably just couldn't hit the holiday, so that's when they're doing it.
Yeah, listen,
that's really bad.
There's a lot of bad things going on, all right? They're probably going to have issues. We'll see.
They might not even sell anything in March. Like, PS Vita released in, like, April, and nobody bought those.
Well, the 3DS also released around that time, but, you know, we'll see what happens. We don't know. We don't know enough at this point. We'll find out later.
All right, I'll come back to you later. Bye.
Yeah, is it just me, or does the new Zelda look like an anime?
That's what I said!
I already said. Oh, you did?
Yes!
You probably cut out again.
Oh, my God. Alright, well, let's finish off with the games coming out this week, because there isn't really anything.
What's coming out this week?
Deadlight Director's Cut for PC, PS4, Xbox One. This is some shit.
What?
This is some shit that, it's like 2D, you have stuff. I actually don't know anything about this game. So let's move on to Mighty No. 9, which is coming out for everything except for the Vita and the 3DS.
Wait, this week?
Fuck that.
It's coming out this week.
So people were so hyped about this back when it was first announced. Now,
it's been 2 years.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
They released like that god awful trailer.
Yep. All those delays, bad trailers. I hope it's good. I don't know. I'm not gonna buy it. That's it.
Well.
Yeah.
I like that half-hearted well-wishing. I hope it's good, but I'm not going to support it at all.
Yeah, pretty much. Pac-Man 256 for PC, PS4, shit. Xbox One.
What?
This is a port of some fucking mobile game. It's one of those, like, endless runners, but it's an endless maze.
Yeah, so let me ask you something. Do you have any news for us? Like, anything important?
No, this is about it. There's not much coming out. Umbrella Corps for PC, PS4. You know what that is?
Is that Resident Evil related?
Yeah, that's like the first person shooter competitive multiplayer game.
Oh, what?
Yeah. What is that? Yeah.
And it's like, you know, Resident Evil related.
Umbrella Corps.
Yeah. It's Jesus. I don't know, man. They're trying, I guess.
Oh, dude, it's got a pretty decent review.
Oh, wait, you mean they didn't mess it up?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, this will actually be interesting to see if this turns out to be good. But on June 24th, Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympics for the Wii U.
Yo, game of the year.
Mm-hmm. Looking forward to it. And finally, Tokyo Mirage Sessions Sharp FE for the Wii U. That game's coming out.
What's that supposed to be?
That's the Shin Megami Tensei Fire Emblem thing, where it's like Persona, but instead of summoning Personas, you summon Fire Emblem characters.
What?
Yeah. I was surprised to find out this game's coming out this week. I didn't even know.
Yeah, you get it.
Maybe? I don't get know it, yet. I'll think about it. I'll see what everyone's saying about it. Yo, Ray.
Yeah?
Are you interested in playing the Tokyo Mirage Sessions thing?
Well, let me just Google that for a second. Is it multiplayer?
No. It's the...
Oh, this game. Yeah, of course I am.
Well, dude, it's coming out this week, or next week.
What?
June 24th.
I've had news or something.
I don't know. I might play it, but I was just surprised that it's coming out right now. I was thrown off. It depends on how long it might be. If it's too long, I don't want to play it.
I'm super excited about this game. It's basically like stupid and also it's a good game to tide you over until Persona 5 comes out.
All right, so then maybe I'll get this game when there aren't any other games out. Because right now, I think I have plenty of things to play.
Remember, I'm still very insistent. You'll have more fun if you think about this as Persona 4.5 than either Fire Emblem or Shin Megami Tensei game.
Well, yeah, because Persona is, you know, just better.
That's not what I meant at all.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
No, I just meant, like, from what we've seen, this game definitely looks way closer to Persona than either of the games it's supposed to be based on.
Yeah, well, you know, they're like, this is what sells, and this is what we should release.
But yeah, it's got anime titties, so you get like that, right?
I mean, it has like pop idols, which I'm just like, oh, come on, why you gotta put in that shit into my games?
I mean, Persona 4 had pop idols.
And she was the worst character in the game.
Arbiter, don't want to listen to you say that.
What? Someone's talking shit?
Arbiter's talking shit.
What's he talking shit about?
Rise?
Yo, what the heck?
Worst character. Actually, I don't know. Maybe Yukiko was the worst. It's like a battle of the worst, I guess, between those two.
Wait, Yukiko is the best. Fuck, she was my pick for waifu. Oh, you suck, Arbiter.
No, you guys are wrong.
What, are you like a fucking Shie dork or something?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Wait, who the hell is Chip? I already. Oh,
Chip, you dumbass.
Yeah, I'm all about Chip though.
Ugh.
But yeah, well,
at least have some taste and pick Naoto.
No,
I like Naoto too.
No, I don't like.
She is all right.
I don't like traps.
But I mean, she's not really a trap.
I know, but she might as well be.
Naoto.
Naoto is not a trap.
She might as well be. Although
I think he means like reverse trap.
Yeah, that's it. I got nothing. We can end this. You guys have. You guys got anything to add before we end this?
Yeah, let me add my week just like at the very end.
All right, you better make it quick though.
All right, I spent the entire week watching ReZero. Done.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Not yet. That hasn't happened this week yet.
Last week's episode this week.
Ah, crap, you're right.
That's it for the podcast.
Join
See
us
you
bye.
Next time. Lucas, say bye. Lucas, no!
I'm back. What did I miss?
Say bye.
Bye.
We'll be right back.